Find out and start reaching your weight loss goals today with help from a simple 30-day diet plan with easy-to-follow diet menu recipes and helpful meal prep tips. You will achieve success to lose up to 8 pounds by following this meal plan for a whole month. 1. What is the 30-day diet? The 30-day diet is a viral health movement that is growing in popularity. It encourages practitioners to cut alcohol, sugar, grains, legumes, dairy and additives from their diets for 30 days and is touted as potentially radical lifestyle changes. Followers rave about its health benefits, while others say it's just another unsustainable diet. So does it work and should we try it? The answer will be shortly. The diet is a month-long clean eating program that promises many health and mental benefits. It was introduced in 2009 by two certified sports nutritionists, who promoted it as a way to reset the body's metabolism and reshape their relationship with food. The 30-day diet focuses on the idea that certain food groups can negatively affect the health and well-being of each of us. Therefore, eliminating these foods from the diet is believed to help the body recover from the negative effects and promote long-term health. Most people go on a 30-day diet in hopes of losing weight. However, some others may also use the program to identify food intolerances or achieve certain suggested health benefits. 2. Steps to follow the 30-day diet. The idea behind the 30-day diet program is simple: just cut out foods that can be harmful to our health completely within a 30-day period. After the first 30 days, slowly reintroduce the foods we skipped, and monitor their effects on the body. The 30-day diet has a strict set of rules. It also provides us with a list of allowed foods, as well as a list of foods that are off-limits. For a period of 1 month, participants were not allowed to eat any of the prohibited foods in one way or another. If violated, that person will have to reinforce this regime starting from the first day. The diet's inventors claim that strict adherence allows the body to reset certain foods that can cause inflammation, intestinal upset, or hormone imbalances. Unlike other diets, the 30-day diet doesn't require calorie tracking, portion measurement, or food scoring. In addition, participants' weights will be kept confidential until the completion of the program. What foods are used? Foods allowed on the 30-day diet include minimally processed foods, including meat and poultry, beef, veal, pig, horse, sheep, chicken, turkey, duck, etc. Fish and seafood, fish, anchovies, shrimp, squid, scallops, crab, lobster, etc. Eggs, all types, as well as foods made from them, such as homemade mayo. Fruit, fresh and dried fruit, although fresh is preferred. Vegetables, all vegetables. Nuts and seeds, all nuts and seeds other than peanuts, are technically a legume. Nut milk, nut butter and nut meal are also allowed. Some fats, healthy vegetable oils, coconut oil, duck fat, clarified butter, and buffalo butter. When minimally processed foods were required, the diet encouraged participants to choose foods with the shortest ingredient lists containing only ingredients they recognized. Foods to avoid during the 30-day diet: certain foods must be completely eliminated from the diet. Include sugar and artificial sweeteners, raw sugar, honey, maple syrup, agave syrup and all products containing these sweeteners, as well as artificial sweeteners. Alcohol, includes all beers, wines, liqueurs and spirits. Grains, regardless of how processed they are, all grains, including wheat, corn, oats, and rice, must be avoided. Beans and legumes, most beans, lentils, and legumes should be avoided, including peanut butter. Chickpeas, sugar peas, and snow peas are the exceptions. Soybeans, all soy, including tofu, tempeh, edamame, and all soy-based products, such as miso and soy sauce. Dairy, includes cow, goat and sheep milk, yogurt, cheese, ice cream and other products derived from braised milk. Cleared butter or dairy is allowed. Processed additives, these include carrageenan, MSG or sulfites. Any food or drink containing these ingredients should be avoided. In addition, the diet recommends that participants avoid eating their favorite baked goods, snacks or snacks, even with ingredients allowed by this diet. So, foods like cauliflower pizza and pancakes must be avoided. There's also no cheating on the 30-day diet. Instead, participants are always encouraged to strictly follow the guidelines. If violated, participants on the 30-day diet will have to start their process from scratch. 3. Recommended benefits of the 30-day diet. Following the 30-day diet really seriously is said to have many health benefits. These include fat loss, increased energy levels, improved sleep, decreased appetite, and improved athletic performance. Moreover, the inventors of the diet guarantee that it will change the way participants think about food, as well as their tastes. Proponents of the diet also claim that it can change their emotional relationships with food and their bodies. While these claimed benefits may seem tempting, it should be noted that there is currently no scientific research to back them up. 4. Reintroduction phase. Once the participant has successfully completed the 30-day diet program, it is time to focus on step 2, the reintroduction phase. During this phase, certain foods were slowly reintroduced to assess how participants were feeling with their metabolism, gastrointestinal tract, immune system, and relationship with the body. Food. The suggested way to reintroduce restricted foods is to re-add only one food group at a time. For example, milk can be reintroduced on the first day. They were then encouraged to return to the diet and avoid dairy on days 2 to 4, while paying attention to any other symptoms that occurred. If all goes well, another food group can be reintroduced on day 5 and the process repeated for the food items thereafter. Introducing only one food group at a time while keeping the rest of the diet intact is recommended as a way to better identify which foods are causing negative symptoms, such as bloating, skin rashes, or joint pain. After all food groups have been individually tested, those that are well tolerated can be reintroduced into the diet. Naturally, individuals are not required to reintroduce all foods. In fact, they are encouraged to avoid reintroducing foods they don't miss. 5. Sample weekly menu for the 30-day diet. Those interested in trying the 30-day diet can start with the following week-long menu suggestions. Monday. Breakfast, sweet potato hash with apples, sausage and eggs. Lunch, chicken salad, young spinach and pomegranate seeds in a bowl of pumpkin. Dinner, garlic shrimp with romesco sauce, served with zucchini noodles. Tuesday. Breakfast, fried egg and veggie sandwich with a slice of sweet potato. Lunch, soup with homemade meatballs and kale. Dinner, mushrooms stuffed with meatballs, avocado, tomatoes, and alfalfa sprouts. Wednesday. Breakfast, an avocado, cinnamon and date smoothie. Lunch, zucchini and salad served. Dinner, sweet potatoes stuffed with peppers, vegetables, and avocado slices. Thursday. Breakfast, soft-boiled eggs and asparagus wrapped in prosciutto. Lunch, minced pork with cabbage. Dinner, cod topped with bruschetta and a side of broccoli. Friday. Breakfast, smoothie made with pears, plums, apples, bananas, avocados and parsley. Lunch, frittata made with smoked salmon and asparagus. Dinner, roast chicken served with cranberries and winter vegetables. Saturday. Breakfast, boiled eggs in spicy tomato sauce. Lunch, small burgers made with turkey, bacon, and beef and served with cilantro aioli sauce. Dinner, duck and vegetables cooked in the slow cooker. Sunday. Breakfast, butter stuffed with crab, shrimp and red pepper. Lunch, half a grilled zucchini stuffed with ground beef in tomato sauce. Dinner, stew with beef, pumpkin, onions and mushrooms. Remember to vary your protein and vegetable sources throughout the day to give your body all the vitamins and minerals it needs. 6. Snack ideas for the 30-day diet. Snacks are a great way to stay energized throughout the day and stave off hunger between meals. Interesting snack options that are allowed on the 30-day diet include plantain chips with salsa or guacamole, apples with hazelnut butter, banana ice cream made from frozen bananas, seaweed snack sugar mix, no peanuts, almond milk latte, prosciutto and melon, carrots with almond butter sprinkled with cayenne pepper, hard-boiled eggs, walnut stuffed figs, fruit smoothie and frozen coconut milk. 7. Potential negative effects of the 30-day diet. Some aspects of a 30-day diet program fit well into a nutritious diet. For example, the diet encourages the consumption of minimally processed foods and the intake of lots of fresh fruits and vegetables. However, avoiding nutrient-rich foods like legumes, soy, and dairy can make it difficult for the body to meet all of the daily nutrient recommendations. This can produce negative health effects if the diet is continued for more than 30 days. Also, while rigid rules can be a good way to re-establish eating habits for some people, a restrictive diet that doesn't allow for alcoholism is generally unsustainable over time. Those who plan to follow this diet for the long term are encouraged to record their meals for a few days in an online diet journal such as Chronometer. This can help ensure that daily nutrient recommendations continue to be met. It is an indisputable fact that if we want to lose weight, we need to cut our calorie intake. Due to its restrictive nature, the 30-day diet can help create the calorie deficit we need to lose weight. Lose a few extra pounds. However, unless the food choices made on this diet become a habit, weight loss may not be sustainable in the long run. As for the benefits advertised by this diet, there is no scientific research available to support the claims. However, it is true that some people may unknowingly develop a food intolerance, and restarting the diet can completely redefine their eating habits.